Hey guys, today I'm going to show you two of the first steps to doing your foil embossing project. To do this, you're going to need a piece of foil within its frame. You're going to need three little tools to draw on there. You're going to need a pencil, an eraser. It might be nice to have a sharpener. And you're also going to need a post-it. You only need one sheet to get started. The first thing you're going to do is make some space for yourself on your desk, right? So let's clear these guys away. And you're going to draw on your post-it. You can see how nicely your post-it's going to fit in the center. So that gives you a good size on which your image is going to be. Okay, so now it's time for you to actually decide, what do I want to draw on here? And I actually found two images in two different books that I want to combine together so that I get, you know, my own design. One of them is this cool little brocade decoration that I found in this costume book from the 17th century, and I thought it was super cool. The second motif I'm going to use is a chain pattern. I really like the handle on this sword, and so that's my inspiration to do a chain pattern around my flower. So the first thing you're going to do is just take that post-it and get to drawing. Use a pencil, erase as necessary, and try to think about creating as much texture as possible in your design. So definitely at the base of my flowers, I'm going to put some texture. I'm going to make sure that I have, you know, some different weights to my line so that it adds interest. And then I'm going to kind of do a final check by, you know, placing my post-it in my frame and seeing if I like it and make any changes. Okay, so now I'm going to take my image on my post-it, place it on top of my metal square, and see, are there any changes I want to make? What do I want to do around the sides to just make sure I'm using that whole square? And I think for myself, I'm going to do that chain pattern around the flower, and I'm going to do that by chasing from the front, so I'm not even going to include it on my post-it. So now I'll take my post-it, and I'm actually going to stick it on the back of my metal square. Here is where I'm going to use my orange wood stick, my paintbrushes. I'm actually going to be using the ends of them, so you can see I picked a small, a medium, and a large so that I would have those sizes to choose from. And on this first pass, I'm going to use the orange wood stick because it's the skinniest. Oh wait, I forgot to put a magazine down. You have to have a magazine or a little stack of papers underneath your metal so that as you push, the metal can be received by kind of a soft material instead of the hard wood. If you just do your repousse over the wood desk, then it's not going to push out and give you that dimension that you want. So I'm just tracing over my design with the orange wood stick, the pointed end, because I want the skinniest line possible. And then I'm going to flip it over and see if I want to widen it out with one of my two paintbrush ends. So experiment for yourself with different widths of lines. If you want to go straight to a thicker line, that's fine. You do what is necessary for your particular image. And I'm also going to speed up this process so that we can get to more directions. It's a little weird, but make sure you go over every single line and you can lift your post-it every once in a while to kind of check your progress. Now I also added that chain pattern in by, you know, chasing the metal on the front. I didn't actually do it from the back, I did it from the front. And I'm just gonna show you, I just came in on the side with my little stick and I made my chain pattern, which I got from Zentangle actually. So you can think about any patterns that you want to add there and how chasing versus repoussé is going to play with each other. But what I'm going to do next is actually take my medium-sized paintbrush and go over the lines again from the back without the post-it there so that I can just widen out some of the lines that I want to have a little bit of a thicker definition. Every once in a while, I'm gonna just flip my work over so that I can see how I'm doing on the other side, and then I'll flip back and I'll keep going. So now I'm flipping it over and I'm chasing my lines from the other side. I'm also adding a dotted pattern, which is gonna cover up this random punch-in that I had in one part of my metal at the top. And that's it. Take a second look, see if there's any areas you've missed or you want to punch in or out. Look over your texture, see if any lines are missing, and you're done. You're ready for the next step. See ya!